get it out.
Ready over there. The January 5th, 2016 Wentworth Town Council meeting will now come to order. Everyone would please bow your head for the invocation. Dear Lord, please be with us as we take up the town's business tonight. Please be with those that protect us both at home and overseas. For it's in your name we pray. Amen. The next item on the agenda is approval of the town council agenda. Everybody has a copy there. Make a motion we approve the agenda as amended. Yvonne has put an amended item on there.
A second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Next item on the agenda is approval of the town council meeting, December 1st, 2015.
I make a motion that the minutes stand approved as written.
I second. Have a motion and 2 seconds. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. We don't have any old business. We'll move on to the new business. We have a consideration of a sidewalk construction agreement between the NC Department of Transportation and the town of Wentworth, and that's NC 65 near Tyre Dodson Road. George?
Mayor, I would like to recommend right off the bat that we table this particular agreement until consideration in February. The reason for that is you have my notes here, administrator notes. Since that time, there have been discussions with involving Donald Huffines from DOT and me and Pat Kane and Frankie Jones from Smithmore Leatherwood, and then finally Jimmy Travis with DOT in Raleigh. And the agreement that you have there was the original draft, and they're simply not ready. I waited until today, and Frankie got word from Jimmy Travis that they should have something to us from DOT. They're hoping by the end of the week. The work is scheduled to begin somewhere around the 1st of March, and having this agreement signed is a prerequisite to that schedule, but it's just simply not ready at this point in time. And a couple of things happened. We were initially sent a sidewalk construction agreement, and that's what you have a draft of here.
Right.
And then they realized that we really should have a sidewalk maintenance agreement. And Frankie finally got directly in contact with Jimmy Travis, and they've been trying to work through some of the details of that. They're doing a good job of looking after the town's interest there, and so it's simply not ready. I did point out in the notes that, of course, the street light has been installed. I don't know if anybody's been down there or not and looked, but it's definitely illuminated a whole lot better in that area now. I'm hoping that by the end of this week we have the final draft of the agreement.
Is that something we need to get signed in order for them to get started in March, or can we wait till...
We will have time in February, I think, if we get it done in February. I've made it, I think, in my discussions with Donald Huffines and definitely with Pat and Frankie, and I think Jimmy Travis is also aware that this needs to be taken care of. But our next meeting is February, is it 2nd, I think, Yvonne? And I think we'll have, if we get it done then, that everything will be okay. But, and the other thing, and Pat may want to address, or at least tacitly, just so you're aware, he's had some concerns that he's expressed about liability issues with sidewalks. And
right.
Pat, I was wondering if you wanted to at least touch on that at this point, too.
Sure. The concern that I have is just that the town be aware that when it is obligated for maintenance of a sidewalk, the town does not have, it's one of the few things that a town or municipality does not have governmental immunity for. Mm-hmm. So if the town is found to be negligent in the maintenance of the sidewalk and someone is injured as a result, then the town is liable. So my recommendation, to the extent the town doesn't already have an insurance policy that would cover any claims made for negligent maintenance of a sidewalk, that that be investigated and looked into and secured. Because if, in fact, God forbid, I don't expect that the town will be negligent in any manner in maintaining the sidewalk, but if even if a claim is made, you likely want to have insurance that would protect the town from liability should a claim be successful against the town.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that you have insurance on this building and on the rental property, so you know, I just don't know the scope of what the insurance.
What are the liability extents to there?
And that's something that when you they do the annual audit and you apply for insurance each year, that you have to fill out this form and it asks about roads and sidewalks and whatever. So you have to list all of that.
Well,
and
we'll
then
have
they'll
to
adjust
let them.
The policy and the premium.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but the thing of it is we'll have to let them know, unless the liability extends to something that we secure, you know, in say the middle of the policy or something, we probably should let them know, or at least look at the policy and check how the liability is worded and go from there. We may need to contact them.
Right, and it renews each year in May, so that'll be about the time. But yeah, I think as soon as the sidewalk was completed, that we would want to report that that's under our.
And during the winter, I guess Georgia had to go down there with salt and a shovel.
I would assume, and that was something I was going to ask Pat, because I would assume that we would be responsible for salting it and clearing it if we had inclement weather.
Yeah, that's maintenance.
Yeah. And is that so? That would be considered part of maintenance. So if it weren't to be cleared and someone were to slip on it,
yeah, or negligent if you don't get it out.
Correct. So. And that's it's an exception to governmental immunity law. It's actually called the sidewalk doctrine. It is one of the very few ways in which a municipality can be held negligent.
Okay. Well, we'll look into that before we let anybody walk on it.
You going to buy me a snow blower next?
May get you a sidewalk snow plow if I make them. In the front, maybe a little Husqvarna.
It beats the heck out of just a shovel.
And let me just follow up on something George said about what the main holdup is with getting this agreement with the DOT done. It's, as George said, they originally sent the document that you have in front of you, which is titled Sidewalk Construction Agreement,
right,
representing that this was going to be the agreement that we entered into. Then when we suggested some changes be made to it, they adopted some changes, rejected others, but one thing that they did was a bait and switch, and they sent back they claim these are just form agreements that the DOT enters into,
right,
with everybody. And what they sent back was a sidewalk maintenance agreement.
Different document.
Which is all well and good, except for the fact that this original document that was sent has a section entitled funding, which lays out very specifically the department shall be responsible for the cost of the project. The estimated cost is $122,000.
Right.
The document that they sent back had no mention of funding whatsoever. The explanation that we were given was, well, that's because it's not a construction agreement, it's a maintenance agreement, and so there's no issue about funding. Well, the problem is by sending us a document that addressed funding, our position is that it now becomes necessary to have it in the agreement, because
right,
otherwise it looks like the course of dealing of the parties originally contemplated that the DOT would provide all the funding, and then that came out, and if it's not in the final contract, if I'm on the DOT side, I'm saying, well, we're not responsible
Can we just sign both contracts? I mean, because this was for the funding, and then sign the maintenance contract also? I guess that would have been.
I don't think that
possible.
I don't think that's possible.
Okay. Right.
Well, and so part of what
they're going to get the funding in the
what we're asking for
they're
is that
come
they
up
just,
with a hybrid
they
contract,
just put
right.
a they put a clause in the maintenance agreement that acknowledges that the construction cost is going to be borne in full by the department. So there can't be any question about, you know, if they pay half and then say, oh, no, the town was responsible for half, that there can't be an ambiguity like that.
Did you see anything else in this document that needed to go into the maintenance document?
No, we actually, we saw some things that were not in this document that we recommended be put in, and some of those were put in and some of them weren't.
I mean, right.
Our typical course of dealing is ask for everything and then we'll get most of what we want, and
right,
we'll agree to let some of it go. Right. So the DOT is not very interested in negotiating this stuff. Their response is, well, these are form contracts that we enter into with 278 municipalities in the state of North Carolina, and our response is, well, we don't represent those municipalities, but we represent the town of Wentworth, and we're going to make sure the town of Wentworth is adequately covered.
Right.
So,
and the other line that they use is that these were documents that were approved by the Attorney General's office, and so that's what they go with, rather than trying to negotiate right with us on that. By the way, this is a copy of emails and the different agreements that have gone back and forth so far.
Well, hopefully they'll get us something by February so we can start in March then.
And the reality is, if it comes down to having to sign something that's, if the DOT won't budge, then the town's going to have to make a decision as to whether or not to go ahead and sign something, understanding that there is at least some modicum of risk.
Right.
And it's my job to make sure you guys are aware of that, and if
right
you want to take that risk, then you can.
Yeah. Okay.
But I'm not going to sit here and not at least make the effort to get full coverage.
Right. Yeah. That's what we pay you for. Okay. Thanks. All right. Move on to B, the fiscal year 2015-2016 financial report. Yvonne?
Okay. I'm just going to review the first page of the financial report. That's just an overview of the next few pages. The next few pages list each line item in our general fund. And if you have any questions about a particular line item, I'll be glad to try to answer that. But this is a report for a six-month period, July 1 through December 31st, 2015. You see that our cash and investments by fund under general fund, the total is $792,874. That's the capital management trusts, which is basically our savings and our checking account. And in the capital reserve fund for recreation, we have $109,933. And I would like to note that at this time, not at the end of this fiscal year, but right now, our general fund available fund balance is approximately $760,000. So we have increased our fund balance by approximately $77,000 in the first 6 months of this fiscal year. So I think that's a, well, we haven't had a capital project, so that's the reason
right
that our expenses are a lot less and we've been able to save. Revenues for year to date is $340,972, which is about the same as this time last year. Expenses is $255,651, which is approximately $187,000 less than this time last year. And again, that's because we don't have a capital project going on. So we're in good shape. We're on target with our budget, and we've had no budget amendments in the first 6 months of our fiscal year and don't foresee any, except maybe at the end of the year, just to align everything up so that our budget is more in line with actual what we have at the end of the fiscal year.
Okay. What do we owe? We did borrow some money to keep from having to use them, our fund. What do we owe in the post office right now?
They're
just approximate. You know.
Yeah, okay. I should have looked that up. We borrowed $150,000. And I think that we probably owe about $100,000 right now. We've only made two payments.
Yeah, that's not bad. We'll just save up a little money. Get that paid off as quick as we can, too.
Well, and I think we did say that by about March or April, if we saw that things were looking pretty good with that, that we may consider an additional payment,
too. Yeah. We've paid off everything early so far.
Yeah, our minimum per year is about $30,000 with the 30 to 35 alone.
How is the new policy with funding requests working? Are y'all still getting in applications?
A few, and we had actually someone with the Sheriff's Department contacted me this week by email that they plan to ask for me in the next fiscal year. So I sent her a copy of the policy and the application form and advised her to turn that in for either the March, February or March meeting so that you guys would have it for your budget work session.
Good deal.
And that's what we've told. We haven't had a lot, but when we have, that's what we've told them.
Okay.
So I think it makes it a lot easier, that process.
Yeah. Anybody got any other questions for you on? All right, we'll move on to C, the Wentworth Historic Preservation Committee membership, which is an amended agenda item. Consideration of amendment to the bylaws of Wentworth Historic Preservation Committee, membership and terms of office. Everybody's got a copy of that. It should be under your financial report. And we just need to amend the bylaws to allow six people right now, correct?
Yeah, so that it would state that that the committee consists of six members, okay, instead of five.
All right. I'd like to make a motion that we amend the bylaws for the Historic Preservation Committee to allow six people.
I'm second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Not all those in favor say aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Next item on the agenda is consideration of a reappointment to the Historic Committee, Margaret Perdue, who lives down in the Wentworth Village area. Her post office box is listed, box 63 in Wentworth, North Carolina, 27375. And I would like to make a motion that we reappoint Margaret Perdue to the Historic Preservation Committee.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Not all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. And would also like to appoint, make a motion to appoint to the said committee Miss Nancy T. Link of 753 Camp Dan Valley Road.
My second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Not all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
I think that carries. On to the public comments. We don't have anybody signed up. Sheriff, since you're the only person up here tonight, I just wanted to ask you a question. Yeah, with everything going on in the country, I always feel safe in Wentworth. You know, during a parade, you know, you think about everything else that's going on, but we had your guys all around. And, you know, of course, here in Wentworth, they're going in and out all the time. We see them in and out all the time. But I feel comfortable, and like you guys are watching everything you can and taking care of us. But I know you're at some heightened state, you know, with everything going on.
Yes, well, you know, we're dealing with some issues all across the country, and we're aware, and we're being briefed and receiving information on whether it be domestic terrorism or terrorism concerns, and then your standard criminal activity. But we're out working, we're paying attention, and when we see any threat issues, we try to make sure we get that out to you as quickly as we can. I was coming here today just to let you know that we're looking forward to working with the town council, Mr. Mayor, and doing everything we can to make sure that you feel safe and the local community is safe. We're going to do our best. Of course, you know, we went operational with our communication center, and that was a big hurdle, but now we're operational. I think all the kinks are out, and we're rolling on. And we're working on our firing range project, which has been underway. Hopefully this fall we'll have it completed up near the landfill for our training purposes. But as far as general safety here, I think that all the officers will receive their training in active shooter response and other concerns. And again, we'll continue working with our churches, our businesses, and anybody else that has a concern about safety concerns, particularly in those kind of situations. Other than that, we're prepared for any threat comes our way. We're going to do our part.
And I guess around here, the biggest target to the schools and the county that time.
Well, yeah, in this time, of course, about a month ago, we received a call about a person that may have had a firearm down at the mental health center, and they made notification quickly. The guys and girls responded very quickly, contained the situation, and again, were able to take the person into custody without incident. And turned out to be a pellet pistol, but again, like I said, we take all threats serious. And I think everybody, when they do their responses, Deputy Terry here, he does an excellent part. He is my main backup here, but we all work together as a team. And if you have any concerns here about, you know, any day-to-day or any safety concerns that we might want to look at, please don't hesitate to give me a call. Okay.
Thank you. Mr. Mayor, we appreciate you and your force.
I had a question, relating to an event that happened recently in the community, I think sort of shocked everybody over Family Dollar. And I know you can't comment on ongoing investigations, mm-hmm. but, it sort of struck me, I was thinking about this, does the Sheriff's Department, make programs available for, elderly or people like that to teach them defense methods and things that they could potentially use in situations? Or
generally, we get calls more from the churches and stuff like this, but if, a senior citizen center or someone had called us up, we would come in with our crime prevention officers and talk about ways for personal safety, how you can better situational awareness, and better be safe. I was out of town when that occurred. I did do a follow-up, and I made contact with Ms. Vernon. And I know her from several years ago, but I didn't want to check on her. But, if we get that request, whether it be a church's business or any other group of people that want us to come in and talk to them, we will bring in our persons that specialize in those areas, particularly our crime prevention, and try to teach people about situational awareness and how you can better protect yourselves.
But, with an elderly lady like that and a walker, two people like that can take advantage of her. We need tougher laws, and folks like that just need to go directly to jail for a while.
It's a very bad situation, and when people prey on our elderly and the persons that can't defend themselves as well.
And she is okay. She expected to make recovery as far as from
I talked to her over the Christmas holidays when I got back from out of town. Mm-hmm. I received the call, and then I talked to her about 2 days later. But my understanding is she's doing better.
Okay, that's good.
Sheriff, you might also want to point out about the Tall Trees Community Watch group that's meeting here, and the Sheriff's Department's been helpful with those folks in doing that.
That's correct. We're trying to keep our community watch groups, and they may not meet every month. They may meet every quarter. But it is very important we keep that contact, the communication, whether it be through emails or through the other alerting systems we have in the county, but just make sure we stay in contact. And when we do see certain problems arising in certain areas and stuff like this, we try to push that out to those different community watch groups. So the more information you have, the better you can protect yourself. But yes, sir, thank you. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Appreciate it.
We'll move on to the announcements. The next regular meeting of the Wentworth Planning Board is January 19, 2016 at 7 p.m. in the Town Hall Council Chambers. The next regular meeting of the Wentworth Town Council will be held on Tuesday, February 2nd, 2016 at 7 p.m. in the Town Hall Council Chambers. And if nobody else has any further announcements, I'll make a motion.
I have one before we go. Sorry.
Go ahead.
I know that it wasn't under our business, so I'm assuming we haven't heard anything else, but have we heard anything about the bottom line?
No, and I did put some administrative notes for each of you to read through. There's one in there about the county's thing about fracking, and there's just some general information about the postal, but have not heard anything back. You've got in the notes where I tell you that the mayor did send a letter, and you've got a copy of the letter there too that you can read through and kind of see what the argument was in favor of appealing that initial decision out of Greensboro. So you might want to enjoy reading that. But we just haven't heard anything yet back from them yet on that.
Okay.
All right. Now, there's a motion on the floor to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Meeting stands adjourned. Thank y'all for coming.